What's up, guys? It's Sean here with the Sean Adeli Book Channel, and today I have for you a bit of a different type of book. I picked up my first Stephen King novel for a while, and I decided that it is time to do the Dark Tower series. And I've been pretty much emming and awing about this book for about 7 or 8 years now, that I should pick it up, I should read it, I should get into it. And it was just kind of one of those moments, no time like the present. I took a little trip to LA, thought, you know what, let's give it a try. So we're going to do a similar, as we always do, spoiler, non-spoiler sections for the book. This was my first Stephen King book that I picked up since Shawshank, back about like 7 or 8 years ago. And Shawshank is one of my favorite books of all time. I've also read It. Bit weirder. It's very different types of books. But the Dark Tower series, we're going to talk about book one particularly, which is The Gunslinger. And I was intrigued more than anything else. He definitely captured me. He definitely got me interested. Stephen King has a very unique writing style. It's not for everyone, I can easily see. There is some unique choices. There is some unique tastes as far as setting and storytelling and the way he describes. However, it was very easy to get into. It was very clear. I definitely understood exactly what was happening in the story, which was a problem I was having with, say, like Snow Crash. And I'm currently reading Malazan book one right now. And a little bit all over the place for the first like 4 or 5 chapters so far. So the book was very, very streamlined. At a very base level, it's the story of the gunslinger, and his name is Roland, and his journey through some type of dystopian, purgatory-esque style world. We haven't really been given a lot of information about what the world is, why the world is this way. There's obviously stuff wrong with the world, but there's people there. It's very unique, very, very interesting, very, very dark setting. That pretty much gets embedded into you from the first few minutes of reading the book. It's dark. And he's pursuing the man in black. We don't know who the man in black is. We don't know if the man in black is bad. We don't know if he's good. We just know he's searching for the man in black and has been searching for the man in black for years. And it was honestly very intriguing. The story, trying to figure out, okay, are we following the good guys? Are we following the bad guys? What's going on? There's a kid involved. It's very interesting. There's a lot of twists. Stephen King's kind of has unique philosophies on how he approaches worlds and his vision of what he wants the story to tell. And I thought this was a very, very good first entry. Based off my research and what I've seen online, it seems like this is not the best Dark Tower book, and that the series just skyrockets as you get farther into it. And based off the booktubers that I've followed and have seen their reviews on it, that seems to be unanimous across the board that each book just takes you higher, higher, and higher, and higher. So I'm totally invested. I'm very much looking forward to getting this series under my belt and having the reviews set out for you guys. So book one, we are done. We'll go into the spoiler section here real quick. It won't be very long, but spoiler-wise, not much to really discuss as far as the spoilers go. The main thing that apparently a lot of people were surprised was that he did let Jake die. I actually felt that Jake was going to die the second that the prophecy came out. I'm like, oh, okay, he's going to kill the kid. Interesting. Was immediately how my mind read it. And so I wasn't shocked at all when the kid did die, but it did make me question it because of the amount of times it just kept bringing up to the point where even Jake was like, you're gonna kill me, aren't you? I know you're gonna kill me. Can we turn around? Like, let's turn around. And then I'm like, okay, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe he's gonna change his mind because of the amount of times this is being brought up. It's very interesting. But it kind of felt like they're taking you down that path to then let you go under and Jake being the surprise. But I'm still, the ending was very, I'm very lost. I don't exactly know. I'm like, okay, this is very interesting. This whole, what's in the tower? Why are you going to the tower? Why do you have to go to the tower? What's the importance of the tower? And this, the god that's in the tower, I guess, in this situation, because the man in black is just a pawn in the story. And the historic flashbacks were interesting. I'm the reference to Merlin, the city, the way he became the gunslinger, all of that was very, very cool and fascinating. I love, you know me, I love lore, I love backstory. I want to get into the nitty-gritty. I want to know why the world is this way and where did it all come from and what happened and all. So that's absolutely fantastic. Love all that. And honestly, I'm pretty excited to pick up the next novel because I've been told by pretty much everybody that I've checked out reviews from that it's fantastic. And it's just, the series just gets better and better and better. And that because of the gap, there's like an 8-year gap, I believe. This book is written in the late 70s, and I believe the next installment is late 80s. So there's like a 7 or 8 year gap between the books. And apparently Stephen King's writing style becomes the more modern version of Stephen King in his in the story. So more than anything else, I'm excited. Stephen King has always been an author I've very much respected because of the magnitude of his work. And I am more than happy to get involved more and pick up the rest of these books and invest in the entire series. To be completely honest, I do not know. I'm going to do a quick Google search how many books there are in the Dark Tower series. But I believe 12 was what I thought I remember seeing. I could be totally wrong. We have The Gunslinger, Drawing of the Three, Wastelands, Wizard and Glass, Wind Through Keyhole, Song of Sis. We have 7. Okay, there's 7. Is that it? Is there 7? I should just Google this, shouldn't I? That would have been a lot easier. How many Dark Tower books are there? I thought one of them was put out quite recently. Yeah, one was put out in 2012. There are 8 books. So between 1970 and 2012, the series dragged over 42 years. Yikes. It's like gonna be us with Stormlight Archives by the time we get to the end of it, pretty much. It's like, all right, well, there's 6 books left. It's going to take us another 20 or 30 years till we get to the end of it. Good news is there's a lot of books to talk about. I'm going to be ramping up a little bit on my books and the series that we put out. I should be putting out the second, the First Law, the sequel trilogy, the Age of Madness trilogy, that is coming out very, very soon. I will be doing a full Witcher run, a full Harry Potter, Wheel of Time, all of it, all the books, Lightbringer, they're all coming, don't you worry. Let me know what you guys thought about this series. If you've read it, tell me, should I keep reading it, should I give up right now? Let me know your thoughts. I'd love to hear it. I'd love to engage more with the people who view the books and view the channel. Thank you guys so much for watching. It means the absolute world to me. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Talk to you soon. Bye.